Hi, my name is Theodore Goshis with botguru.net, here to show you the 1 minute Facebook apps. As soon as you make purchase and you download, you're going to drag and drop the 1 minute Facebook apps folder wherever you'd like to store it. When you open it up, you'll see a games folder, the application, and an instructions file. The instructions file is a PDF document, and when you first open up the application, double-click it, you'll pop up with a registration. You'll have to use your details that you used when purchasing, your first and last name from purchase, your email, and your receipt or ticket number. When you click register, it'll go ahead and register the program, and then it will open up for you. Let me just drag this in here for you. Now inside this program, you'll see there's a few different things that you could do. You've got create single application, multi-app creator, and an instructions folder. Inside the instructions folder, it will bring up the PDF for you in a web format so that you can go ahead and view it directly inside the program if you like. But let's go ahead and get right into creating a single application. When creating a single application, you're going to go to mokimedia.com, download any one of their games that they have available, and then you will load it here. When you click browse, just go to your downloads, wherever you saved the file, and you will go ahead and select the zip file. You'll put in a name. Your install domain, and we'll just use something. Your Mokimedia publisher ID number. And application ID, secret, and these other two tabs here is for your Facebook application information. Those can be found when you create your Facebook app inside the developer area inside of Facebook. Those are extremely detailed and laid out for you in the PDF document, step by step, how to create your application inside of Facebook so you can get this information. For now, we'll just use some fake information for this. App secret, canvas page, always has to end with a trailing slash. Canvas URL is the URL of your website, including the folder in which you're storing the files. And remember, if inside Facebook for your Canvas URL, you use the www, you must use it here as well. You can't have one in one area and something different in another. Choose your folder name, and since we called this Rider App on our server here, we're going to go ahead and call it Rider App here as well. And what this will do is it'll create the application folder for us so that all we literally have to do is just upload it straight to our server. If you have a banner ad, CPA offers, anything you want to show above or below the application, you can enter those in these two tabs here. When we go ahead and we click the play button, it says it's loading, running through the checking procedure, and then it'll create it directly on your desktop for you. Your application has been created. When we open up that folder on our desktop, you see here it's named Rider App. And it has all the files directly inside here for you. All the files are already pre-configured. All you have to literally do is just upload this folder from your desktop to your web server, and your application is 100% live. the way that the multi-app creator functions is that it uses a CSV file, and you would load that through here. However, go to the instructions page, click yes, hit play, and what it'll do is create an example CSV file for you. Now, this file will show up on your desktop. Let me open this up for you. And you'll see here that it has these categories at the top. These categories are the exact same as inside the single app. It has all these different areas inside this CSV file. Instead of a browse function, obviously, for the zip file, what you're going to do is in this column here is list the name .zip and then fill in all your other information. Game title, install, domain, Moki publisher ID, Facebook ID, secret, canvas, URL, the save to folder name, top ad, bottom ad, and the zip name with the .zip attached to it. You won't have to put the full path. If we grabbed writer.zip, and that's what your file name is, that's all you're going to have to put in there. One other step that you would have to take is that once you download all these zip files and you fill in all your details here, inside the application folder, which is right here, you have a games folder. You would want to open that up, go to your downloads, copy it, and paste it right inside this games folder. That way it will pull these zip files based on the names that you gave them in the CSV into the application and literally build hundreds of thousands of Facebook apps, creating the folders, all the coding, and all the files for you, so that all you simply have to do is upload it to your server and you're done. If you end up having any questions, feel free to contact me on botguru.net or contact admin@botguru.net. Thank you.